I came into the field in 1957. One didn't know how memory worked on a biological level. When you, the rules of memory, you know, repetition practice makes perfect, but one didn't know what happens in the brain. There were ideas. One idea that Kandel had, one of the founders of neuroscience, is that nerve cells talk to one another, and that contact point where they talk to one another is called the synapse. And he suggested that maybe synapses change in strength with learning. But there were many other ideas around. So I developed a very simple system in which you could explore this in some great detail. Only a few nerve cells control the behavior, and I showed that Kandel was right, that memory leads to a strengthening of connections between nerve cells in the brain. Moreover, I was able to go on and define the molecular details underlying that. I showed short-term memory involves a change in the pre-existing proteins, but long-term memory involves the synthesis of new proteins. It leads to an alteration in gene expression, which leads to new proteins that then give rise to the growth of new synaptic connections. This gave us the first biological insight into how memory is stored, and memory is an important process of the brain. So when you lose memories, it's a biological process. And everyone, to some degree, has a weakening of memory with age. That falls into two categories. Age-related memory loss, which is a milder form, actually begins somewhat earlier, involves a different region of the brain, and I think may be readily reversible with intellectual games and things like this, exercise, good food, good diet. And Alzheimer's disease, which is a much more serious disease, which one needs treatment for. In Alzheimer's, you have a bad protein that kills synapses. I'm also interested in what perpetuates memory. How do you remember your first love experience for the rest of your life? And I found a very interesting mechanism, a self-perpetuating protein at the synapse that can just keep going. And in memories that are sustained for a long time, that is what becomes active and carries it. I'm also interested in disorders of memory, post-traumatic stress disorder, in which a certain memory is activated for a very long period of time. It turns out this also involves a self-perpetuating protein of sorts. So I'm interested in how memory is altered in the various conditions.